Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at the new hair component design system. This enhanced hair system allows you to add different hair mesh components to your character's face that provide a much more natural look and better conform to the face during your character's facial movements and expressions. You can find the hair components that we're going to talk about in the Content Manager in a few folders that are new for this version. The component design hierarchy is shown on the diagram here. You can see that all the hair types are grouped and categorized separately into their own respective areas for better organization and easier access. You can see detailed component structure for beard and eyebrows here. As you can imagine, this new structure allows for much more control over the details of these facial elements. The hair is also split into various components as well. You can customize and combine them all to make a wide variety of cool and unique looks. Let's take a look at how to apply and assemble these components on your character's head first. In this folder, you'll find a few of the hair components that we're going to apply to our female's head one by one. Generally, you'll want to start off with the base element and then add on from there. You can see that we can also add in the bangs, back, and a bun on top as well to complete the look. It's really that easy to get everything on there quickly. Let's take a look at adding beard elements to this male character now. Basically, you just follow the same process by adding a mustache, narrow sideburns, a soul patch, and a beard element to create a unique look. If I try to add this chin strap beard design with the current one already applied, it'll come up with a prompt asking if I want to add this additional element or replace the existing one. This is because they occupy the same area of the face. I'm going to replace instead of adding in this case. After that's finished applying, we can add this little Viking beard element as a finishing touch. Be aware that this element is actually an accessory and therefore doesn't have skin weight values like the other component meshes. This means that it won't morph along with the facial expressions and it will act more like an attached accessory. As such, it can be independently moved and scaled like an accessory, which is an ability that the other facial hair elements don't have. If we go into the attributes, you'll see that it's currently attached to the jawbone, and therefore that bone will drive its movement. This can be demonstrated if we go into our facial animation tools and move our character facial features around. When we do so, you'll see the Viking beard will remain stationary while the other elements morph around with the lip shapes. However, when we want to move the jaw, the Viking beard will also move along. If you want to save a hair accessory to your custom library, it's actually quite easy. All you need to do is make sure that you have it selected, zoom the camera into a good angle, and then press the plus key in the Content Manager. That will automatically save it to the correct custom folder so you can reuse it on any other characters in the future. You can do the same thing for other elements as well. In this case, we're taking the sideburn element and repeating the process. You'll notice that it will save to the same custom folder as the previous example since they are both beard elements. Once you update, you might be wondering where all of the old legacy hair content has gone. If you follow this folder structure, you'll find it all organized in a legacy subcategory. In iClone, the folder structure is slightly different. You'll find everything under body part and hair, and from there you'll find all of the legacy content under the hair subfolder. Okay, finally let's take a look at combining all of the components together to create a complete look. There are three main group folders, hair, eyebrow, and beard. You'll find them indicated by the small white icon on the top left of the thumbnail. We'll start with the beard from our previous example, and then go into our hair folder to apply this embedded male hair. It will add as a single component since it's an entire group. From there, let's go into the beard group folder, and if we select our thick chin curtain hair, it will replace the current style completely. There is no replace or add option with group templates. If we reapply the Viking template, you'll see that everything will be replaced. If you want to save the group, just press the plus button at the bottom of the Content Manager as we did before. However, this time, since we're saving an entire group of elements, it will ask us if we want to save the hair, beard, or brow group. We'll save the beard group for now, and you'll see it will save to the Content Manager in the Custom tab. We can do the same thing for the brows as well, and it will save the brow group, although this character's brows may be pretty basic. Generally, it's recommended to zoom slightly into the relevant area of your character's face when saving the group in order to differentiate it later based on the thumbnail. The highest level of the hierarchy is called Style, which combines all the different groups together into a unique combination. You can save the entire style to your custom library by using the plus key at the bottom of the Content Manager once you're in the Style folder. It will then save to the Custom Style folder. This new style category allows you to easily and quickly replace every single face element grouped as a single style with a single clip, which is much more efficient than applying each element one by one. A couple of restrictions to note here. The first is that the facial hair system is not supported with regular CC3 and CC1 character bases. If we try to apply one of our style templates to the CC3 base character, you'll see that it will come up with the option to either convert the character to a CC3 base plus, or else apply the hair content only. If you want to convert the base, select the option for Go to Modify panel. At the top of the Attributes tab, you'll see the option to convert your current base to a CC3 base plus. On the other hand, if we apply that style template to our regular CC3 base and select Apply Hair Only, you'll see that only the hair on the scalp will apply, but nothing else. That's really all the basics for the new hair component system. It fulfills a much-needed realism gap for characters' facial hair, where it is now a mesh with skin weights that can conform to all of your character's facial expressions and distortions. You can also save time by saving and applying complete style templates as well. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. Make sure to check out our forums over at forum.reallusion.com as always, and I'll see you in the next video.